whacking us with a stick, but we certainly feel like we've been whacked with a stick. But we're going to stop whacking at the Wall Street Illuminati. And how are we going to fix that arbitrage so that we can create jobs in our society?
I have been amused over the last couple of years, the sense of somehow maybe it's up on Wall Street. I think most folks on Main Street feel like they got beat up on. There's a probably a big chunk of the country. There's a big chunk of the country that thinks that I have been too soft on Wall Street. And that's probably the majority, not the majority. Now, what I'm trying to do is just trying to be practical.
So yeah, right there we have him defending Wall Street, but that probably is a lot easier than what he has to do now, defending a president with 36% of Google ratings. Thank you.
On this, the president faces a massive decision as the House and Senate announce an agreement on a new Russian sanctions bill. The White House again doesn't entirely appear to be on the same page as whether or not President will actually sign this.
Is President Trump going to sign the Russian sanctions bill?
You got to ask President Trump that. It's my second or third day on the job. My guess is that he's going to make that decision shortly.
The administration is supportive of being tough on Russia, particularly in putting these sanctions in place, and we support where the legislation is now. We'll continue working with the House and Senate to put those tough sanctions in place on Russia.
So, two different messages. You wrote the whole, I don't know if it's Sarah Lucci, and support for Hillary Sanders. Let's talk to Tara Palmieri, senior political analyst and White House correspondent for Politico. So, Tara, you know, if you look at this both ways, both options, from the president's perspective, walk me through what happens if he signs or vetoes this legislation.
There's a possibility that President Trump could add a signing note to the bill. He's going to sign it and then say, you know, that he doesn't actually agree with the sanction. President Obama has used that in the past. I think what you saw in the Sunday shows is the fact that there wasn't really a coordination of the messaging, likely because of scare, which he said he's still new on the job. But I think, you know, that's a lesson learned, that when you do represent the White House, you have to know affirmatively.